Hi everyone, today I'm going to show you guys why you should probably consider to get yourself a camera cage. There are different brands out there. Today we have here the YC Onion camera cage. This video is not sponsored by them and it's just for demonstration purposes, and let's get started. One trick I often use with this cage, I'm using my wireless Go unit like this. So I have the receiver in the middle and then the mic placed on the right, just like an onboard mic to get some rough audio from the ambience or atmosphere. And then if I want to vlog or have to interview someone, I can just simply detach the mic on the right side and then place it close to myself to capture my voice or to capture someone else's voice. You can see that there are a lot of mounting points here. The more better you get into filmmaking, the more special accessory tools you'll need. So for example, if you want to have a better audio, you definitely need to attach a mic, or also if you want to have focus peaking or very specific exposure assist tools, then getting an external monitor will help you a lot. You could maybe attach one of the accessories onto the DSLR camera, but if you want to attach more accessories, then you would need more mounting points, and that's when a cage comes in and is very handy. And before purchasing your cage, it's always great to definitely go through their website and check very thoroughly how it's designed, because sometimes how you place your accessories might be different than mine, and you will notice that some of the parts are blocking each other, so not perfect. For example, with the YC Onion, I like most of their mounting points. The only thing I don't like is once it's attached, you will see that on the cage, the tripod plate will be more offset to this side. And that's a bit stupid, because if I want to put it onto the gimbal, then it's very offset to one side, which makes the balancing a bit hard, or it's gonna hit the axis a bit too early. They do give you a quick release plate system. And if you have that on, then of course a tripod plate can be attached more into the middle of the camera. The only problem though is I already unified all my quick release plates, so therefore this Litchi quick release plate is not suitable for me. Some of the cage have these amazing tools already attached to them via magnets. This is very handy, because if you're shooting in a very stressful situation and you need to quickly tighten your quick release plate, you don't necessarily have to go through your pockets or your bag to find the tool. Another good thing about the cage is, even if it's a small project, with the cage, with for example a matte box and all the accessories around, you will look more professional and it will give the client a better impression, so you will be most likely hired for the next job. So now here we have a fully loaded GH5 cage system. This does not look like a DSLR anymore. It already has a lot of professional accessories, I would say, on there. We have LED light, external monitor, microphone, and also lavalier mic, so two choices, and also an image transmitter. This image transmitter is very interesting. It's called CineEye Air, and this image transmitter allows your client to see what you're shooting. He'll be feeling more involved into the project and quickly can give you some feedback and communicate if there are any parts that he doesn't like. So the whole project overall will get better and you'll be able to most likely be hired again for your next project. And of course, the other great thing about having a cage system for like professional shoots is just to be prepared, because suddenly the client calls out for a very creative shot where you cannot use the autofocus but have to pull the focus manually and probably wirelessly. And in this case, if you didn't have a cage, you wouldn't even have a good mounting point for it. But now, because you had a cage on set, you won't be standing there awkward and you can solve this issue immediately by attaching a wireless focus system. In general, it really does give you just way more options. Also, we've all been there. We want to sell our camera, but then we notice after 1 year of usage, there are already some scratches on there and so on. But if you had a camera cage, then it would most likely protect most of its part when you're on set and you're shooting the project just as a 16:9 project. But then the client is like, oh, maybe I do want to have just two shots, just quickly done, but in a vertical video style for Instagram and so on. Then you will notice with the cage, you do have the option to, for example, just take your quick release plate and attach it onto this side. Again, I love these tools attached via magnets, really handy. So now the cool thing is you can see that on this side, we have also a quick release plate, and you can suddenly just flip your camera and then shoot our 9:16 video on a tripod. So there are also many cases where you don't want to use a cage. If you're shooting a travel vlog or you just want to be lightweight and operate also a lot of shots onto the gimbal, then definitely don't get the cage. It will just increase the whole weight of the camera package. But if you're shooting a, let's say, client video where the client definitely needs to see the image, or if you're shooting special documentary where you need good mics that you need to attach to your camera, then this is the moment where I would say definitely go for a cage, because it will make your life easier and also more professional. So yeah, what do you think? How would you usually use your cage? What's your setup? Definitely let me know in the comments below. And if you liked the video, definitely hit the subscribe button and see you in the next one. 再见.